We want something that has this nice two-step forward, one-step back approach. And the way you get that is through being in sync. Now, the only trouble is that it's trouble, you know, it's very difficult and it's very troublesome for many creators to figure out how to be in sync, because everyone has a different idea of what it means to be in sync with the market. But let's just kind of look at some examples here and see what most traders go through. For example, you can see this market here. We're in a sustained downward move, and then we start to move upward. So most traders, and myself included, when I was trading this day, would say, well, you know, you've got to buy around here in the bottom. It looks like we're going to be heading upward, so we've got to buy and try and catch the move up here before it goes too far up. And then look what would happen. It would go straight down. All right. Same thing works on the opposite side. You see a market go straight up. Perhaps some trading room or chat room you're in says, you've got to short this. It's hitting resistance. There's too much supply at this level, so you've got to sell. And look at this bar here. We close towards the low. So this is your point to sell before it comes all the way back down. So you jump in and sell, and then look what happens, okay? I'm sure this looks familiar to a lot of you. How can we alleviate this? How could we be in sync with the market when it's so difficult, when all these people are telling us, giving us different signals? There's too much supply. There's too much demand. There's a Fibonacci number here. There's, you know, indicators are crossing over. Well, we came up with technique number one, and this is something you've heard me speak about all the time. It is simply the buy-sell line. Now, if there were one tool, if I were stranded on a desert island and I could only trade with one tool, it would be this. And I use this in everything. It doesn't matter what market I'm trading. It doesn't matter what time frame I'm trading. And the buy-sell line is simply the 50-period simple moving average. So I want you all to plot a 50-period simple moving average on whatever market, whatever time frame you're looking at. So I don't care if it's a 5-minute time frame, a 4-hour time frame, or a daily time frame. You should always have a 50-period simple moving average plotted. And what you want to do is ask yourself, if price is above that 50-period, then you will only be looking to buy, or in other words, you'll only be looking for buy signal. You're not going to just simply buy at the market. You need a buy setup, okay? Either, you know, something that is in your strategy or one of ours, but you can only look to buy if price is above. And conversely, if price is below, you can only look to sell. It's that simple. When once my mentors taught me this, everything fell into place. I was no longer trying to pick tops and bottoms. I was in sync with the market. And I'm not going to tell you that this works 100% of the time, but remember, we're not, you know, going for that. There is absolutely no indicator or method that works 100% of the time. We're looking for consistency. And there is tremendous consistency with using the 50-period simple moving average. So let's look back at those charts. Remember, we wanted to buy here because this particular chat room told us that, you know, or the trading room said, this is where you have to buy. It's going to bounce back up. And look what happened. Well, if we had added the 50-period simple moving average, we would have seen that price was below. And so if price is below, we have no business even buying anything. So you see how this would have kept you out of trouble. Now, on the other hand, we have this example right here where, let's say there was someone told you there was so much supply at these levels right here. As you can see, it was 1, 2, 3 times we came into these levels. So there's tremendous supply there according to our technique or indicators. And, you know, you always, you know, never want to go in the face of supply, so you should sell right there. So you would have sold, and look what would have happened. What happened to the supply? Now, supply is subjective. Supply and demand is very subjective. So it's difficult. We want something that's more cut and dry. And the thing that is cut and dry is the 50-period simple moving average. So all you need to do is plot the 50-period simple moving average, and you would have seen that price is above. So you wouldn't have even thought or considered going short. You would have just only looked for buy signals. So you see what a great tool this is. As I stated, I use this every day. It's not, you know, above my trading, even though I've been trading for nearly 40 years. This is something I continue to use and something that keeps me out of trouble and helps me be in sync. If you see here on a longer-term chart, you can see the same thing happen. So if we're looking at a monthly chart, whatever market this is, we see that once price is above here, we're only looking to go long, and once we cross over and we go below it, we're only looking to go short, okay? Remember, if you have any questions, I don't know if people came in late, please wait till the very end of class to ask the questions, okay? All right, so now let's look back at some forex markets for last year, the best and some of the best and worst performers. So we're going to look at the euro-yen, And we're also going to look at the Australian dollar and see how this technique, technique number one, could have helped you with these two particular markets. We're going to look at weekly charts just so that we can encompass the entire chart, okay? So we can go back entirely from the beginning of 2013 to the end of 2013. Now, the euro-yen had performance results of 27% from January to December. So that's great. I mean, this currency pair was up 27%, had a really nice and strong uptrend. Now, if we look at the chart here, we see that this is a weekly chart. Now, someone could have looked at this and said, well, we're going up, and it looks like we're curling over. So I think we're going to short it. Once again, there's some supply or some Fibonacci here that is resistance. So it's probably a good sell in the euro dollar in the first quarter of the year. So we should sell, but look what would have happened, okay? So once again, you're out of sync. By trying to pick a top or a bottom, in this case a top, you would have been out of sync with the market. How could we have been in sync with the euro-yen for the entire year? You just simply add the 50 periods and moving average. And we see that price was above on this weekly time frame. So there's no way you would have lost money if you're looking at weekly charts, because you would have been in sync with the market. The only way you would have lost money is if you would have tried to short the euro yen. And if you use this simple tool, you will never even consider shorting the euro yen. And so you've only had some very nice upward moves. How about the Australian dollar? Australian dollar was very poor performance this past year, down 22% from January to December. If we look at the chart here, we see that in the beginning of the year, the first quarter, we kind of had no real movement. We're kind of just going in a range here. Someone could have said, you know, we're going to decide to buy this. Maybe it's going to break out of this range. It looked like we hit a bottom right here. Someone else could have said, oh, that's some Fibonacci number. You've got to purchase it because it hit the Fibonacci support and all these indicators lined up. So let's say in some chat room they told you to go long, and then look what happened. So how could we have stayed out of trouble on a weekly chart using our technique? Well, we simply add the 50 periods of the moving average, and we see here that we had a little oscillating above and below. But once we were consistently below here, there was no reason you would have ever considered going long the Australian dollar. You would have missed all of this downward move. Remember, once again, because you want to be in sync with the market, that will give you that consistency. And the reason why we use a 50 period simple moving average is because it transfers over well into all markets. A lot of people like to use a larger time frame, a 200 period moving average. Some people like to use a 20. Some people like to use a Fibonacci number is 34. The main point is that the 50 seems to transfer over well regardless of what time frame. So that's why we use a 50 period simple moving average. If you're looking at a 5-minute time frame, a 4-hour time frame, or a monthly time frame, it seems to work the best as opposed to all the different time frames. And remember, all we're looking for is to see where price is in relation to that. It's not some magical trading tool that will tell us when to buy and when to sell. It's just getting us on the right side. That's all we're trying to do. So if price is above, we're looking for buy setups. If price is below, we're only looking for sell setups. All right, so that was technique number one. You can all start using that as early as you like. In fact, I recommend, suggest that you should start using it right away, because you'll start to see this consistency in your trading. Remember, picking tops and picking bottoms is a recipe for disaster. Okay, I'll repeat it again. Picking tops and picking bottoms is a recipe for disaster. Take it from someone who knows. I lost about $500,000 in the crash of 1987 trying to pick a bottom. So I know personally how much that can work for just a limited time, but then how you can give it all back. So never try to pick a top or a bottom. It'll work maybe 9 times, but on the 10th time, you'll give it all back, okay? So remember, it's a recipe for disaster. All right, so let's go on to technique number two. So now that we know that what side of the market we should be on, we want to get confirmation. So we want to confirm when the right time is to enter. We want to use some type of tool that will fine-tune our entries, all right? So these are the rules for confirmation method. And remember, this is not a strategy. This is probably where most of my students have difficulty. They think the confirmation method or technique number two is a strategy or a system. It's only a entry tool. It's a tool to enter on that can fine-tune your entries. And so this is how it works. Regardless of what strategy you're using, it can be one of mine, it can be one of yours, it can be something that you got from another educator, or it can be something based on the tide of the ocean. It doesn't matter, but whenever your strategy gives you a buy signal, rather than just purchase at the market or place a limit below, you know, trying to pick a bottom, after an entry signal has been given to go long, only buy once price trades 1 to 3 pips above the next consecutive bar. So in other words, as long as your strategy is telling you to go long, don't buy unless we trade above the previous bar. Okay? Same thing for sell signals. Whatever strategy is to go short, don't sell at the market. Don't try to pick a limit. After your strategy is giving you a sell signal, only enter or sell, once price trades 1 to 3 pips below the next consecutive bar. Okay? I know this may seem a little confusing or wordy, so let me show you some chart examples here. Let's say that this market, whatever it is, doesn't matter. I purposely deleted it just to show you the concept, because I want you to focus on this concept. Let's say you're in some trading room, and they say, boy, we've got to buy this. It's taking off. It broke out of some resistance here, you want to call it a supply, whatever you want to call it, but it's taking off. You got to buy. So normally what most people would do is they buy the market because they don't want to miss it. But remember, our technique is, that's okay. I mean, if the signal is valid to buy and we're above the 50-period simple moving average, instead of buying at the market, you only want to buy once price trades above. So if it does go above, you're not going to, lose that much money had you bought right here, okay? So you just want the confirmation that it's going higher. And as long as your strategy is telling you it's okay to buy, you continue to use this technique, and you'll track it down all the way. As you see here, we never traded above the previous bar's high. Until right here. This is where you would enter, okay? Now, you'd enter at this point, and look what happens. You got confirmation, and that's when the trend resumed. Now, this technique, once again, is not a strategy. So we don't just want you to say, oh, I'm going to just apply this to any bar, and once the bar trades above the previous bar, I'll go long. No, you have to have other sets of rules that make up a significant setup or a buy strategy, okay? So this is not a system. It's not a strategy. It is just a technique to fine-tune your entry, give you confirmation that once you've confirmed you've traded above, you're going to go higher. Even though this is not 100% guaranteed, once again, it's a great technique that you can start using as early as today, and you can use it on any strategy. It doesn't have to be one of mine, okay? So rather than purchasing right here, even if you had purchased right here, it would have been the right thing to do because ultimately the currency pair went up. But what happens with most people is they'll buy, and then look what happens. In the next day or two, it goes straight down. They get discouraged, they get scared, and they throw in the towel, probably at the place where you should be getting ready to buy. So we want to just fine-tune our entry. Same thing would work if you go short. Okay, let's say the original sell signal was right here to sell, so you would sell right here, but we want to wait until it trades 1 to 3 pips below. As long as the signal is still valid, and this is where you get in right here, when it traded below the previous bar, and you see you have a much better entry. Okay? We're just trying to fine-tune our entry with this technique. So we've given you a great technique to get you on the right side with the 50-period simple moving average, and we've given you a great technique for entering. These two techniques, in my opinion, will substantially elevate your trading and get you on the road to consistency. But remember, we're talking about consistency. Nothing is 100% foolproof, regardless if you're listening to one of my presentations or someone else at FXTreet. Nothing works all the time. In fact, many times you'll see that you'll have a perfect setup, and then you'll enter, and then you'll get stopped out. You'll say, boy, I followed all of Steve's rules, and I got stopped out with a loss, and it didn't work well. So how can we fine-tune this even more? How can we, give ourselves even more of an edge? We've given ourselves a great edge with technique one and with technique two, but is there a way to give us an even better edge? Now let me just show you right here. Here's an example with the Canadian dollar. Now price was below, and then we went above, and let's just say we got some type of signal to go long on this down bar right here. Let's say it was based off of the full moon. Now it doesn't really matter, okay? But let's just say your strategy said this is where you buy. Rather than buy at the market right here, we want to place, as you can see here, had you purchased at the market, look what would have happened. You probably would have said, boy, what did I do? And then you would have been stopped out. What we want to do is place the confirmation technique, where as long as the strategy is our strategy, still saying it's okay to be long, we just continue to track it until it trades above the previous bar's high where these dotted green arrows or lines are. And this is where it traded right here. So it doesn't matter that it has to close above. All that matters is that intra-bar, it trades 1 to 3 pips higher. So that would be your entry point. And that's where you would have bought the Canadian dollar. This was earlier this past year. So this is a perfect example. Well, once again, as I was stating, these are great techniques to give you a greater edge. But how can we even elevate this even more? We've just given you two great techniques you can start using right away. And I would recommend that you study them a bit and paper trade for a while. But I use them in all of my trading. It doesn't matter if I'm trading forex or if I'm trading e-mini or stocks. All of our, I would say 99% of all of our methods incorporate either one or both of these techniques at specialist trading. So I've given you this for free. That's usually reserved for our members. But one thing here I want to share with you is a way in which you can even elevate and increase your odds for success even more. Because, as I said, many times you'll use this particular technique and you'll still get stopped out. Let's say you would use this and let's say we never went higher and then we went lower. Okay, so is there a way to even give us a more of a confirmation, some way that we can elevate our chances for success even more with using these two techniques? Well, yes, I want to introduce and take just a short minute to talk about putting it all together with the PETD. Now, what exactly is the PETD? It's a proprietary color bar algorithm that is exclusive only to members of Specialist Trading. And what it is it shows you a series of green bars that tells you when a short-term uptrend is in place. And it shows you a series of red bars when a short-term downtrend is in place. Now, these are best world examples here when you see everything red or everything green. But from time to time, you'll have a splattering of red and a splattering of green in the overall trend. So here's what we want to share with you. A particular buy pattern is when you have an overall uptrend, meaning that price is above the 50-period simple moving average, you have a lot of green. From time to time, you'll see a splattering of red. So the very first green bar that occurs after a red bar is your confirmation for a buy pattern. So that's your setup bar, and then you'll buy if it trades above. So let me show you right here. As you see here, the overall trend is up, but now we have just a few red bars. Now the first green bar we have is our setup bar, okay? Now we apply the confirmation technique, meaning we'll purchase right here, and that's our buy above the first green bar. And look what happens. Okay? The same thing works on the downside. If price is below the 50-period moving average, technique number one, all right, what you want to do is the first red bar that occurs after a green bar is a confirmation for a sell. So, in other words, we don't see it right here, but we're below the 50-period moving average. The majority of bars are red, and then we have a small amount of green bars. The first red bar appears is our signal to go short, but we cannot go short of the market. We use technique number two that we just taught you. So we'll only go short if we trade right below here, which we did. That's your signal to go short, and look what happened. Okay? All right, now let's look back at the worst and best performers of 2013, the euro, yen, and the Australian dollar. How could these three techniques have helped us? Well, we're above the 50-period simple moving average, as we shared with you before, okay? But what is our signal to go long and use technique number two? Well, we simply add the PETD. You can see here the majority of green, but every once in a while we'll have a red bar followed by a green. That's your signal to enter once we trade above the first green. And look at all these buy setups you could have had going long the euro-yen on a weekly time frame. How about the Australian dollar, the weekly chart? Well, right here we got below, significantly below the 50 period, so we're looking to go short. As you see here, we add the PETD. We had one trade to go long here because we're above the 50. And this would have worked. I mean, actually, this was just 100 pips, so it's not really a bad move. But things changed, and now we're below the 50. We had our first red bar, and look what happened. You could have shorted and taken advantage of this. We had a splattering of little green bars, but the first red bar that appeared, that's your signal to enter, and look what has happened again. Now, I want to share with you a signal that was given last week to our members in the Canadian dollar. This is the daily chart. We see here the 50-period price is above. That's technique number one we just taught you. Technique number two, we're buying above the signal bar, and the signal bar was the first green bar that appeared. And that's right here. This was actually 100 pips to the upside. Here was another signal for about 50 pips, but this was the last one right here. Okay, we have a red bar followed by a green bar. So you would have entered on the 7th of January, and look what happened in the Canadian dollar. Okay, so we have technique number one, we're above the 50 period. We have technique number two, we use the confirmation mode where we only bought once price traded 1 to 3 pips above. But then the thing we want to find out is, well, which is the bar to buy above? What is our setup bar? And that's where we use the FED. This is what we teach you in class. We teach you where to buy, where to place your stops, where to exit, and a multitude of different ways in which to trade it. Now, if you wanted to go to a different time frame, here's a 4-hour chart of the Canadian dollar. You see once again how the 50 period works in any direction and in any time frame. Here was the first green bar after a series of red bars, and we are above 50. So you purchase 1 to 3 pips above, and then look what happened. This was on the 6th going into the 7th. So if you want to trade the smaller time frame, everything works the exact same way. You don't have to change. You don't have to worry about supply and demand, support and resistance, trading rooms, chat rooms. All of that stuff only serves to confuse you. It's too subjective. All you need to do is use the techniques we shared with you and then some simple tools like the FED. All right, so let's recap. Technique number one, the buy-sell line. What is it? It's the 50-period simple moving average. And why do we use the 50? Because it transfers over so well onto every market. In other words, you don't want to just use moving average for intraday time frame, and then once you get to daily, you have to switch to another one, and then once you get to weekly or monthly chart, you have to use a different moving average. It's better just to use one that fits all markets and all time frames, and that's why we use the 50. It has worked better than any other time frame that we've seen. But remember, it's not a strategy. It's only a tool telling you what side to be on. So when we teach you this as an educational company, we're telling you that we are trying to get you to be on the right side by using. And then we share technique number two. That's the confirmation. Once you get a setup bar that's telling you, okay, all the pieces of the puzzle came together and it's time to go long, or all the pieces of the puzzle came together and it's time to go short, rather than just buy at the market or place a limit below, use the confirmation method. If you got a buy signal, regardless of what strategy you're using, only buy if price trades above the previous bar. And if you're going short, only go short if price trades 1 to 3 pips below the previous bar. Okay? So these are two great techniques that are usually reserved just for the members of specialist trading.